Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, one and all. Thank you all for being here in DevNet Create 2021. It's always a pleasure to meet and create all our DevNet enthusiasts and have some of the best conversations with all of you. Thank you again for making it here today. Now we will be discussing about chaos engineering. Test your network security before someone else does. It is an interesting approach to improve the network software reliability with chaos engineering strategy. Well, honestly speaking, this will definitely going to bring some good changes the way network testing happens currently. Before that, I'll quickly introduce myself and one of my co-presenter, Utkarsh. I am Sayali, working as a network consulting engineer in professional services Cisco. I am passionate about learning and implementing different technologies, and hence I have been part of automation and data science related initiatives, along with the regular customer deliverables. So automation, network security, data science, these are some of my key focus areas, which is why I am here today in front of you talking about network security. Well, before diving straight into the session, imagine if I would have asked you, say, around 50 years ago or 70 years ago, which is the next thing that is going to break the market or which is going to bring some revolution to the industry. We would have never guessed that the internet is the thing that is going to bring this change. Well, talking about internet, there was good old time where internet was only for people, where people could search the images, search the movies, upload some documents on internet. You know, happy lonely world, we could say. But now with the advancement in technologies, newer and new products are getting introduced, manufactured day in and day out. And these are being launched into the market. And we as a consumer, we are using it every day in our life. But at the same time, these edge devices or IoT devices are opening more and more security vulnerability threats for the system or for the data streams, right? So I would like to mark a great quote said by a great philosopher that if you are revealing the secrets to the wind, you should not blame them for being exposed to the trees, isn't it? So what else could be true during this current scenario? As you all must have observed that during this pandemic period or this time span, many organizations all over the world have faced security breaches. Let's take a look at some of them. You name it, and each and every company at some or the other point of time have had some of the major security threats or vulnerabilities in the network. Key point that we need to focus here is that most of these breaches happen during the production network. Well, as you can see, Capital One, Equifax, LinkedIn, and many other companies have had breaches during the production network. And what happens if these things happen? Obviously, this is going to reduce the valuation, data privacy, monetary loss, right? So we all agree with the fact that security is really very important. To bring security in our day-to-day transactions, technologies, and devices, we need something that can bring trust. So we are coming up with a new approach. We call it as a chaos engineering. Well, chaos engineering is something which is a discipline of experimenting on distributed systems in order to build the confidence in the system's capability to withstand the turbulent conditions in production. Oh my God, I'll give you in a very quick and simple format that break your systems on purpose. Find out their weaknesses and fix them before they break when least expected. Oh my God, this is scary, right? You must be thinking this is a crazy idea, Sayali, of injecting failures into the production system. Like, why do we need to break our own system, right? So you will be getting answers to this question in next couple of minutes. So before that, let's take a look at how our network system or network testing mechanism looks like every day. So nowadays, most of the network testing mechanisms are scenario based, or I would say hypothesis based. For example, if I know the test case A and expected output B, then there will be a scenario like that. But that's not the case in production network, as it is a very dynamic environment. Any constant changes and, you know, it causes unexpected emergent behaviors and errors. And this will mostly lead to network downtime. So there is no testing mechanism to predict failures in the production system. And obviously this is going to results are usually binary and they do not uncover new information about the application. So it's very difficult to predict these failures, right? And when downtime occurs in the customer system, it causes a whole list of problems. And all of them can be very, very costly to the organization. If the network is down for longer than few minutes, I'm mentioning few minutes, an organization can be losing or facing a lot of money in fines, maybe in penalties or SLA refunds, which eventually leads to further loss of revenue. And during that, customer is also experiencing some very worst case scenarios because network failures happens in the production system that takes time to, you know, scale up after the network outage occurs. And this will obviously reduce the customer satisfaction and possibly even the adoption of new features. So if you are asking your customer to adopt some new features of your product, it will be very difficult for you to convince the customer, right? So this is the customer experience today that we are facing. So there might be few questions that are running through your mind. Why can't we reduce these network failures in the production? Or why can't we reduce the security breaches and downtime in the production? Why can't we just predict these failures proactively and avoid them in the future, right? Because there is a gap. There are some fundamental challenges for identifying the root cause and suitable readiness for failures that encounters in production network. The primary reason is the production network system cannot be replicated in a lab environment, both in terms of hardware as well as software diversity. Not only this, the infrastructure or the network is changing and it is becoming a very dynamic system that leads it to difficult to control the complete network. And these constant changes are causing unexpected errors, which we cannot predict always. Also, it takes a lots of cost from an organization perspective to set up a testing environment and scale to a production environment. So let me ask you this question again. What if we conduct small, very minute failure testing scenarios in the production system, in the live production system? Is it making sense now? So this is going to build a confidence into the network, into the customer's network system. We need smarter ways to test systems continuously. And one strategy that is gaining a lot of popularity nowadays is chaos engineering. So Netflix has been using chaos engineering in their microservices and cloud-based production system to give a smooth user experience. Well, honestly speaking, we took it a step further to incorporate this into our security networking infrastructure. How we are going to do this? We are mainly focusing on three main components. The very first one, as you can see on the screen, is plan and experiment. So based on whatever network topology you have in your production system, you need to build a test case scenarios. It will get designed with the help of smart agents or on yourself, you can build a hypothetical one system that will help you to plan this experiment. For example, let's see if we could send some wrong packets from router A to router B and we will calculate how the system is going to behave after that. Is there any downtime? Is there any latency issues or what exactly is happening when this particular test case we are running in production system? Once it is done, we are going to contain the blast radius. What you mean by that is that we are going to execute a smallest test case that is going to teach us something. And that will help us to create more and more such cases around the network. Once you find an issue, well, yes, job well done. Otherwise, you'll have to increase the blast radius until you are at full scale. So these are the three main steps that we can follow whenever we are working on chaos experiments. Well, honestly speaking, this is going to incorporate a metric of fuzziness as well with the help of machine learning. So this is a loop where you can, leverage this one particular test case scenarios into your system continuously after some time period, some time interval. And once you get the results, you can feed those results into your model again and again so that you will be getting a good machine learning model or a fuzziness that will help you to stop this network failures in the future. The advantage of this, we will get to know real-time testing, not only based on known test case scenarios, but also on random case scenarios. So we can use a random metrics to leverage that into the system. So these are some of the very important key takeaways or magical features we can see of chaos engineering that we can use whenever we are trying to experiment these things out there. Now, the performance of the network and convergence can be monitored regularly once you use this technique. The very first one is hypothesis. Obviously, you will have to create a hypothetical scenario or experiment with test cases, and you can run all of those test cases with particular time interval into your production network in real events and in production network. Also, this is a continuous process. So it's not like you are just going to trigger it only once. You can have it again and again and again and again. Once you get to know what are all the results that we are getting out of it and what is the exact metric that we can use it again to avoid this in the coming future. So this delta will get calculated and the system performance metrics will get generated. As a result of this chaos test or scenarios that we are designing can be used to analyze and generate some reports out of it or dashboards out of it that will help us to build a repository for the future use. And once again, it is going to minimize the blast radius. So, benefits. This is the main part of it, right? So as a result, once we get this incorporated and start leveraging this in production system, there are going to be multifold benefits for both the customers as well as the organization. For customers, obviously, this is going to improve the service availability and durability, faster adoption of network features. If you're asking your customer to, adopt something, it will be very easy for the customers to take it positively, and there will be minimal network impact. But when we think from the organization perspective, this is going to reduce large losses in revenue. This is going to scale up quickly without losing any reliability of their services. And there is a wider coverage of test cases, which helps in monitoring, which will help you to improve the test cases and calculations and metrics during that period. But with the help of these magical features of chaos engineering, we will be able to secure our system from the threats or from the breaches that are happening around us. But what do you think? Chaos engineering is not only limited to the security. We have huge industry impact out there in innovation, education, development, government sector, and where not. So this brings us to the end of this session. As every technology comes with pros and cons, chaos engineering has its own. But I'm pretty sure we will be using this in different industrial impact in our day-to-day life. Thank you so much for your time. Have a good day ahead.